Hi there. Today I came with another very high quality Android application that is used as a e-commerce application, or you may be referred it as a shopping app also. So actually I have designed this application because of lots of people are requested me to design such kinds of application in this pandemic situations. So most of the people's were selling their items from home or by using online methods. We will use this application for a grocery shop. If you have any grocery shop, then you can use it. If you have any vegetable market or the fruit market, then also you can use this application. Or if you have any electronic product shop or any other mobile accessories shop, then also you can use this application. Okay, so by using this application, you will grow your business by the online way. Let us start with the introduction and the feel of the application. We will go towards our application and let us see how it works. So before going to this, I will request all of you that if you have not subscribed to this channel till now, you can press the subscribe button. Also, you can press the bell icon. So whenever my new updates will be there, you will get them notified. So let's start with the app introduction. Here I'm going to open the app. So here you will see the welcome screen. After the welcome screen, here one-time registration is there. So here the registration is done with the help of OTP, so no one unauthorized person can use the app. So here I will enter my number. Okay, for the demo purpose, I have taken one more option here, that is a guest login. So if you log in as a guest, then all the functionality will not be available. So here it is essential to log in with your alt credential. So here I will press the SMS, so we will get the OTP here. When the OTP is received, it will be automatically detected. So there is no manual entry of the OTP is required here. So after getting the OTP, the next screen is to enter the user details. So after that, you need to press save and continue. So here your account will going to be created. After that, you will see the welcome screen here. Here you will see the home screen is having a very high quality UI. Okay, so all the components we have taken here, they are asynchronously loaded. All the images, all the dynamic components are loaded asynchronously. So there is no issue of lagging the application or the reduce the speed of application. Here the speed of application is much faster than as compared to the other applications, because all the data will be loaded asynchronously. Okay, so here you will see at the top of your home screen, you will see the delivering to. So here whatever the address the user have inserted at the time of sign up process, that will be appear here. After that, you will see these horizontal scrolling banners are there. So that banners you can create as per your need, according to the your offers. Okay, so after that you will see in the home screen, the first section is my favorite. So whatever the you have ordered previously items, that will be appear here more. So these products will be loaded asynchronously. You will see the product will be loaded asynchronously, means when you scroll the items, that time it will loaded. So that will increase your application speed. Okay, so here you can, there is no issue either the items are 1000 or 2000, so that will be loaded asynchronously. After that you will see the category section. So here I have added the 7 sample categories. You can add n number of category here. So here 7 sample categories are there Inside this category, you will see the categories wise all items. After that, you will see the coupon code section here. You will add the different kinds of coupons for the users. So here I have added the sample coupon that is used for the first user to get a 10% off discount. After that, you will see the top selling items. Okay, here you will see the top selling items that is comes from the user's demand. Okay, so all these items automatically scrollable. So here also all these items are synchronously loaded, so there is no issue of lagging the application. Okay, here you will see number of items are there, but it will be smoothly loaded. Okay, so after that let us see the sidebar of application. Here you will see this sidebar image icon is there. After that, the username and the mobile number will be appear. So at the initial stage, you have not seen the profile picture here, so for that purpose, or to upload or to change the profile picture, you have to go through my profile session. After that, you will see here the profile change option. The remaining data will be automatically loaded here that you are entered at the time of sign up process. So if you click through this image, then it will be asked for the upload the new image. So you can go through your gallery and select your profile picture, and then you can upload it, so it will be get changed. Okay, so after that, you will see the my cart option is there. So here you will see all your cart items. Here currently there is no cart item, so it will showing as a empty. After that, in my order session, you will see the total order placed by you. Okay, so here I have placed one sample order previously, so that is appear here. After that, I have taken the one rating option. So whenever your application is on Play Store, the user can rate your application through this option. After that, share option. If you want to share the application with the different peoples, then you can share through this option. Okay, after that, contact us. Here the user will contact through admin by using either email address or the mobile number. Here one more main option I have taken here, that is a WhatsApp. If you click on WhatsApp, it will direct towards the WhatsApp, and user can automatically make the contact with admin. So here suppose I will select the WhatsApp, then it will be directly goes chat box of your admin. Okay, then after that, you will see the privacy policy. Here I have created privacy policy. So whenever you want to publish the app on App Store, that time it will avoid the error coming while uploading. So that's why here the privacy policy is uploaded. After that, you will see the logout option. Okay, if you press the logout, the user login is get deleted. Okay, after that, suppose here I have to purchase the item from this my favorite category, then just I will press the item, then you will link toward the product details. Okay, so in product detail page, you will see here the product names, then price of your product, then how much stock is remaining in your stock. Okay, if the stock is 00 or there is no item available, that time the add to cart button is automatically disabled. Okay, after that, if you want to share the product with your friend user, then the option is given. Then after that, you will select the number of here you will select the quantity of the product. Suppose here I will increase the quantity, then you will see the price will automatically increase or decrease. So here I will make the quantity as a 2. Here you will see the price is automatically increased, and then I will press the add to cart button. After adding the item, then the add to cart button is get disabled. That will avoid the maximum time adding the same item into the cart. Okay, so here for that purpose, to avoid the user clicks, the add to cart button is get disabled. Okay, after that, suppose I want to add a particular item from any category. Okay, suppose I want to add the item from the soap and detergent category, then just I will press this category. Then you will see here all the item comes from this category. So here you can also see these products loaded asynchronously. If you scroll it upwards, that time you will see simultaneously product are fetched from the database. All the products cannot be fetched from the database at same time, because it will increase the speed of your application as it loaded asynchronously. So that is the advantages of this application. So there is no lagging in this application. Okay, now suppose I want to add this item. So I will press on this item or press the add button. Then here I will keep the quantity same as a 1 pack. Here you will see the price and their unit. The unit may be either a pack, okay, or piece or kg, or it may be liter likewise. So here I will add this one product here. After that, suppose I want to add the product from this top selling category, then I will simply press the atom. Then again I will press the add button, then it will get added to cart. After that, you will see at the top right corner of your screen the search option is provided. Okay, so this search option, that will be again available in the bottom view also. So by pressing the search button, you will go or you will link to search screen. So whatever the products you have added in your database, that may be either 1,000, 5,000, 10,000, all will be appear here. So these items are from all categories. So you will search any product here. Suppose I want to search here Colgate. So those product will having this word Colgate, that will be appear here. There is no matter either the product is from that particular category. Okay, you will see these products are coming from the different category. It consists of this word. Okay, suppose I want to purchase this product, then simply I will click on that item. Then here I will select the number of quantity and then press the add to cart button. Suppose I want to this item, or I want to purchase this item, then I simply click here and then I will press the add to cart button, then item again get added in the cart. So now if you go through the carts, okay, so the one product we have added from the favorite, one is from the category, and the one product is from top selling item. Okay, we will keep this item here. You will see the minus icon here. That icon is used if you want to remove a particular item from the cart. And another option is there, if you want to remove all the item from cart, you can just press this minus sign, then it will ask you that if you want to remove all item. If you press the remove button, that time all the item will get removed from the cart. So simply suppose here I will press the remove, all the item will be removed here. Okay, I will again add this item, then go through the cart button. You will see the one product is added, then we will proceed for checkout. Here the payment screen will be appear. In the payment screen, at the top you will see your product cost. If you want to add your service charge or the shipping charge, you can add it. Okay, after that, in contact session, you will see all the data will be automatically loaded. The data that is fetches from the user detail that the user have entered at the time of registration. Okay, so all data will be loaded automatically, so there is no need to manually enter the data. But if you want to change the address, okay, that time you can simply edit this data. Suppose here I will show you, suppose here I have to add my apartment, then I will simply edit this data. After that, you will see the shipping date, when you want or when the user wants the order, the date have to be selected. Here I will select the next date, and after that you will see two types of payment option are there, either cash on delivery or online payment. Okay, so if a user select as a cash on delivery, the order will get placed. If user selects the online payment, that time user have to make the payment through UPI. Okay, so here UPI gateway is implemented for making payment. Now currently I will keep the cash on delivery option and then press this button. Now here it will asking for if you have any promo code. Okay, so I will enter the promo code that we have seen in the first screen, that is first user. Okay, that promo code is only applicable for the first user. So here I will press the apply button, then you will see the coupon applied successfully. You save 10% off on your first order. If you don't have any promo code, you can just simply skip the step. So here I will then proceed, and you will see your order is placed. Okay, after placing the order, either you can go inside your order book or you can skip the step. Here we will go inside our order book to see whether the order is placed or not. So here you will see the second order. So here you will see the user name will be there, the shipping address, the mobile number of user, then what the product he ordered, that will be appear here. Here only one product we have ordered. So total items, payment mode, which kind of payment mode the user have used, that will be seen here. Then total amount, that is also shown here, and the delivery date, on which date the user wants delivery, that will be also shown in the order section. Okay, so if you see towards this application, it is a very high quality application. I have spent 2 to 3 months to create this application. Okay, I have solved all the bugs and the issues that we have already faced. So the application is in a ready state. So if you want this application, then you can simply make a contact with me. My mobile number or the email address is given in the comment section or in the video description section. You can simply make the contact with me. Again, one more thing is there, all these products you are seeing, that will be added from the admin panel. We have the admin panel of this application also, so we can add the new product or remove the product, add new category. All these operation will perform with the help of admin panel. Okay, so this is all about the application. If you have still any doubts regarding to this application, you can simply ask me in the comment section or you can ask me on the WhatsApp also. So here my mail ID and the mobile number is given. Okay, same will be provided in the video description also. You can simply make contact with me.
ओके, थैंक यू।